Another common concern when we look at the head of the baby is presence of caput and cephalhematoma. So we have the layers of the scalp starting from the skin. If there is a collection under the skin because of the position of the head or the use of vacuum, it's usually caput, and that is a serosanguinous liquid which seeps out of the vessels due to the pressure around delivery. We have the periosteum, which is the covering of the bone, and if there is a bleed under the bone covering and over the surface of the bone, it's limited by the periosteum to that bone surface. This is called a cephalhematoma. A cephalhematoma typically happens even after non-traumatic deliveries, maybe an effect of the negative pressure during the descent of the head. It can happen in traumatic deliveries and with vacuum extraction as well. You can see it rising after the first 12 to 24 hours. It's usually not present at birth. The blood accumulates. It's limited by the periosteum, which is a tense membrane, so it doesn't keep expanding. And the typical thing about the cephalhematoma is that it can grow for 2 to 3 days, but very rare for the baby to become anemic from it. The blood breakdown may lead to increased risk of jaundice. And what we need to mainly tell the parents is to avoid excessive pressure or forceful massage over that area, because sometimes it can expand. Even after 1 to 2 weeks, I've seen some babies where the cephalhematoma expands. And we also have to tell them that it takes time to resolve. It slowly organizes itself around the edges. It may feel firm, and in the center, it feels continues to feel boggy. And then it becomes firm, a small nodule-like thing after the blood clot organizes. The subgaleal hematoma happens between the galea aponeurotica and the muscle layer. And because it's a loose space which is not limited, it can spread widely. So it's very important that we consider the subgaleal hematoma in any traumatic delivery where there is a loose scalp tissue, where it looks boggy, and on turning the baby to one side, it may run to the side which is dependent. This is because the blood can flow within this loose chamber. Because it's a large area and sometimes an artery-like vessel is involved, it can bleed excessively. Baby can become hypovolemic and go into shock. So it's very important to recognize this quickly. Regular measurement of the head circumference, close monitoring of the vital signs, and observation of these signs, measurement of the hemoglobin, these will guide you.